everyone. Thank you for visiting my channel if you're new here. And today we're gonna do a video about all of my orchids and stuff. So first we're gonna talk about what I've told you in the title and in the thumbnail. And this is the orchid I'm trying to rescue. So I found this orchid. Well, I didn't really find it. I kind of just stole it, but they probably didn't care about it anyway. So someone has buried this orchid in their garden, you know, with terrestrial plants. Orchids are not terrestrial plants, and it was just absolutely suffering. So I decided I'd try to save it. So the crown of this orchid is absolutely destroyed. It will never rebloom again from this point. But there are keikis growing all around the stem of the orchid. So hopefully those will live on and, you know, bloom on their own, hopefully. So I have it into this little contraption I've made. So it rests in here where the fertilizer is, and then I just close the lid and hope for the best. Okay, so now let's talk about this orchid right here. So this orchid is not a baby orchid, it is a full-grown orchid, and it's called an Oncidium sigmorchis pacillum. So it blooms frequently. There are some flower spikes right here and a flower spike right there. And this orchid grows very, very easily inside of my house because I've had it for about a week. So the next plant we're going to talk about is not an orchid. It is a tillandsia plant. So I don't know the species of this tillandsia, but I just thought I'd show you because it's pretty neat. So now we're going to talk about this phalaenopsis orchid right here. So this orchid, I had an accident with it. So I was taking it in to water it because it was cold outside and I didn't want to water it outside. And I dropped it, so the soil went everywhere, some roots were broken, the flower spike of course got broken. And it was actually looking a lot better, like the leaves were upright, but now they're not anymore because it doesn't have enough roots to properly hydrate itself. But hopefully it grows some new ones. So next is this phalaenopsis orchid. So this orchid is blooming for the very first time that I've seen it. So here is the flower. It's a nice pink color that gets purpler in the center. I don't even think purpler is a word. And this bud's going to open next, and then that bud will open next. So this orchid is continuing to have problems with the roots. I think it's transplant shock, but it is definitely still has enough roots to hydrate itself because the leaves are upright. And they're kind of stiff. Sometimes orchid leaves will just be naturally flexible, and sometimes they're not. So next is this orchid right here. So this orchid I got from Walmart, and it was, I'd say, in okay shape when I got it. I did repot it, and I definitely had to cut off a few roots, and it is doing well so far. It's able to keep its flowers, which the color on them, unfortunately, has started to fade away. They were this bright, vivid orange with pink around the edges and purple in the center. So this orchid, this leaf is like this, and this is also why I don't like to buy orchids that are inside of those plastic bags, is because the leaf, like, it got forced this way, so now I can't undo it unless I make the orchid severely dehydrated, and I don't want to do that. So I think that's all I wanted to talk about today. So if you enjoyed this video, leave a like. If you didn't, leave a dislike. If you're new to this channel, check out my channel trailer and my new visitors playlist. And hopefully I'll see some of you new guys in the new video. Bye.
Stars shining bright above you. Night.